Speaking of artificial intelligence, we can easily imagine Siri guiding us online. We can imagine virtual assistants and bots helping us online and answering questions. And you have applied AI to science and healthcare.
As you said, Elena, when you think about Siri, Alexa, and what we call the digital voice assistants, those are systems that use AI rather than being pure AI in itself. And they use, like what we say, natural language generation and processing. And for us as human beings, those systems are easy to understand because they mimic the way we listen and speak. However, in healthcare, AI is transforming the practice of medicine, and it has applications from drug development to diagnosis. And it's not easy for us to understand its functionality in the same way as we understand Siri or Alexa. So AI and machine learning that we use in medicine learns from historical data, from observations. It builds memory from those observations and finally leverage this memory to make real-time decisions. So in healthcare, think of AI as building the digital brain of our healthcare system.
Like encyclopedia of everything that is happening, right?
It takes all the data from the past diagnosis, from the tests, from the successes and failures, from all previous treatments of patients, and it learns. And our role is to replace today's certainties with this new technology. So we work with life science companies to build this memory and leverage all the learnings from the past to make the right decision. And we are empowering those organizations to deliver suggestions to their field teams and their strategy teams in order to bring innovative drugs faster to patients, making sure those new drugs reach patients in need faster, regardless if they are in rural or urban areas. How can we reach them with this AI brain faster by empowering the teams to communicate better and to reach to the right doctors and stakeholders?
So it sounds like a medical GPS.
It's something like GPS where you say, this is the doctor that has the most patients that need this drug. But for a strategy executive, it's more high level overview. Think of it as a map of Europe where you see, this is the key areas you need to focus on. Here we see the patients that are in need. And for higher level, it's even more on a world map where you can see here in those countries you need to access. This is your benefit for your drug in those countries. So it is indeed a GPS, but across different layers of the organization.
Yeah, much more complex. So you're helping to bring the right pharmaceutical to the right patient. And now in the challenging times of pandemics, and we have a number of different vaccines developed all over the world. You can name it. Moderna, Pfizer, BioNTech, Sputnik, Johnson & Johnson, Sinovac. And they're all different. And we don't have much information or information that comes fast enough to us as patients or clients, customers. How can AI help us find the right vaccine to the right patient?
This is close to us now, but this is the problem of the industry for all drugs, for all treatments that are available. But because we have the pandemic, now we live close to this problem. If you look to the delivery of the vaccines today, unfortunately, it's not subject to data or computing. Sadly, it is widely uneven and unfair. As the UN Secretary General said, it is the biggest moral test before the global community. And the delivery of the vaccines at the moment is not equal because we lack data or we lack technology. It reflects the behavior of and the moral of our major economies in the world. The COVID pandemic has created somewhat of a sandbox or like a natural experiment. We've seen what is possible. So let me start even before the delivery. What happened is we moved the whole industry, the pharmaceutical industry, from an average of 10 years to develop the vaccine to 10 months. So that's quite revolutionary. I mean, I know we've been waiting, but this is so new. The positives and negatives of the golden standard of evaluating treatments, which is the clinical trials, the randomized clinical trials, have emerged on the surface. People know what it is. And we've seen that we need flexible, adaptive clinical trials. We can only achieve that using AI, not waiting for the entire trial to finish, but reviewing the results as we go.
Medical practitioner is a human profession, and always the conversation, discussion between the patient and the doctor happens behind the closed doors. So how can we keep this conversation of data collecting behind the closed doors?
We need to establish trust for AI systems only by pushing the ethical and transparent implementations of AI. For example, in Europe, we have the GDPR, which is a big step into protecting personal data. We need to avoid it becoming a barrier to advancement in healthcare. And we know what power lies in AI systems in healthcare. We saw that the countries that got the vaccines early because they leveraged their data. And that's the new currency if we want to move ahead.
Let's imagine 50 years from now, how AI can help us predict future pandemics and tell us much faster, prevent it even.
We saw examples of studies that are happening in the lab where AI can be used to detect the first signs of outbreak when the virus starts. And this is not by using even medical data. This is by looking into data that is coming from searches, public traffic, media announcements to detect anomalies in the change in behavior to be able to flag that there is a markers of an outbreak in the community. We can only do that if there is a global effort that emerges to collect, standardize, and make real-world data a standard and accessible for analysis and prediction for future outbreaks. But I think hopefully those initiatives will kind of start building up now.
Yeah, I agree. How soon can we have AI help us create individualized medication, individualized pharmaceuticals, affordable?
Yeah, believe it or not, we are already quite far ahead when it comes to drug development for individualized cases. And individualization earlier in the value chain is happening. But what the problem is, how can we embrace this individuality, not only in the design of drugs, but also on the delivery of drugs? In order to make that jump, we need data. We need to train those brains with data that doctors will rely on evidence based on scores. An AI algorithm scores the different treatments from 5 or 6 treatments that are available to what is the best fit given the demographic of these patients, maybe the genome of this patient, the genetic profile. What is the best treatment that works? In the future, we can start collecting that data as the baby is born or even before to be able to predict all the risks of the patients for all the disease areas and be able to score it and monitor it. And when we see there is a risk, a red flag, then we be able to predict what is the best treatments for these patients.